Hi everybody, I'm back again with another, not tutorial, but I want to show how I did that fur. I have been asked how I did that fur around my angel's coat when I did the golden angel. And I said that I could make a video to show you. Now, I have showed this already, so I will link that video up here so you can look at that as well. And then, because if you don't get this, then maybe the other one will help you. Or, yeah, anyways. So what I have done, I have colored my coat and the wings and the hair, because those are the parts that are behind my coat. So what I start with when I do this is always to put down a shadow. Now this is the Ferenc Gray 90%, but you can shade with a dark color of your choice. Like if you like the indigo, you can do that, or if you like a green shadow, if you are coloring like the back around green or whatever. So I'm just putting down my shadow color on the outer edge of this, or on the fur line. Now Jen has already put in some dark marks like here and there, and so they are there to help us to see where the shadows should be. So I'm just making them darker, so I don't have to guess where to put it down, because Jane has marked that out for me. So that was my darkest shadow, and then I use a lighter gray. This is the Ferenc Gray 50%. So I'm just pulling that in here. Now this doesn't have to be neat or anything, because you will cover it up with white gel pen or acrylic paint, Posca, which is acrylic paint. Whatever you prefer to use as your white medium, you will just put that on top of here. So I'm just going around everywhere where I already put my darkest shadow, and just making that a little bit wider, so that this shadow, the lighter one, goes on the outside like that. A little bit up there. Just something like that. So now you see this doesn't really look like much, but like I said, don't worry, because we will cover it. You have different types of Poscas. It doesn't matter if you use the bullet type, or if you prefer the pin type, or even the brush type. I can show you. So this is just a regular white Posca PC1M with the bullet shape. So I'm just flicking that over that gray. I'm starting on the outer edge there, working my way around, going over the lines that we have there, and going over, kind of the, like pulling it out into the red on the coat. So I'm just doing this like over and over, building up my layers. I'm gonna let that dry the little bit. I think that that fur should go like that and down like that. There. It's going out over my coat. I can show you that it works with the pin type. So this is the PC1MR pin type. Same thing, still a Posca. Just a different nib. Now, if you are using a really thin nib like this one, of course, it will take you some time to build up the layers and get it where you want it. But if you just keep on doing like this, you will get there eventually. Now, Posca also have this brush pens, which have a much wider nib, so it actually goes quite faster. I'm just putting this down here. You cover so much more, but of course you need something with a thinner line or a thinner nib for getting out or to get out some of the stains, so that it actually looks like it is fur. So I'm just starting somewhere, going my way around it, going the other way there. So. That. So, and this is actually all I do. I'm going over that one. For getting out some of these loose or singles strands, I'll just get my thinner one. This is the pin type. I'm just pulling some of these out. Of course, now I use the Karen markers underneath this, so it will take some time for, or some layers for me to cover that red, because it's seeping through. If you don't have Posca or a white gel pen, just buy any type of white acrylic paint. So this is just a cheap hobby store brand, nothing expensive or anything. So I just squeezed out some of this paint in my lid. My lid that I use as my palette. I have a little bit of water, because I like to water it down just a little bit, not much. Then I have an old brush. Let me see if I actually have it. Where? Yeah. Like this one is just an old brush that I have used for a lot of stuff before. I'm just mixing some of that water into my white paint. And then I'll go over. No, we can do it on the other side. Well, since my brush is old and frayed at the at the bottom, then I will automatically get those stains. I'm just picking up some more. Covering everything I want to cover. Now, of course, I should have painted colored, finished the snowman that is dancing. By the way, this image comes from Jane Fankin's new book, The Fantastical Charismas Tree, which you can order from her website. I will link it underneath there, so if you, for those of you who wants to order it, you can do so. And that is not a affiliate link. I do not earn anything from it. It is only there for your convenience. So this is actually the only thing I do. I go over layers and layers and layers with acrylic paint, or if you have a lot of gel pens, just that. Yeah, so you see, we started with this, just coloring the shadows, and because I'm using white, shadow colors will show through, and it will be underneath it, so it will actually look quite natural, actually. Of course, you can cover them up as much as you want to, but I prefer that they show at least some. Oh, that did not want to. I have to get some more paint on my little brush here. If I'm not happy with what I got so far, I can again go in with my other thing, my pens, and go over where I want some, or where I think that I lost some of the loose reins, and just put them in. And you can use Posca with paint, because Posca is paint, and or even gel pens. Just mix what you have and use it. So I can zoom you guys out a little bit. Now of course this will be even better when it's dry and I will add another layer. So, but that is the technique that I'm using for this fur. So I hope that that is helpful for those of you who have asked me about that. And if there is anything else that you think that I can help you with, just ask and I will see what we can do about that. So thank you everybody very much for watching, and I will see you all later. Take care, stay safe, and I love you all. Bye.